$50 emergency food stamps and spent it on crab cakes, Custom Martinez thought of home, poetry like bread, poetry like fucking, poetry like pubes, bikini line, 2 days stubble, poetry like a single line of thin hair running from abdomen to cock. Poetry like flan, rice luxury no family can go without, gooey fat oozing out of pan, like crab cakes on food stamps, it's not a party, it's survival. Poetry, like bread, like crab cakes, like fucking, is for everyone. Which roughly translated is crone and enchantress in Espanol. She has moles. A hair grows out of one, hair under her chin. She plucks those, shaves her bikini line, and trims down there. Prone to punching in public if pissed off. Worry lines on her forehead mark a lifetime of listening and actually giving a shit. She's manipulative, gullible, a yeller, quick to say I'm sorry. Barges pass people in the supermarket, they have to veer their carts away from her. Holds the door open for strangers as she leaves. Drinks all the wine when invited over for dinner. Spends her last $5 on just about anyone.
Not, hold on, guys.
Okay. Rides her antique broom, drunk late at night past the moon. Sends wishes into the universe for strangers. Curses her allies. Curses herself for myriad blessings undone. Cunt, he mutters under his breath, the old lady slowing down with her blinker on 3 blocks before she turns. I cringe in my seat. Cunt, he yells, pumping his fist to the dashboard in the direction of the woman in the SUV who cut him off. I slouch, cringe. Cunt, he spits at the female driver in front of him who stops for yellow light he hoped to gun through. Cunt, cunt, cunt. I cringe because my twat is not a cunt. And I feel the word cunt cut through my twat every time he throws it out. So I start calling every man I can a cunt in his company. Cunt, I scream, pointing at the guy in Mini Cooper talking on his cell phone and driving really, really slowly. He's such a cunt, I empathize, and he tells me his boss made him stay late to finish a last minute chore piled upon him. You're such a fucking cunt, I murmur when he shoots me a dirty look. Cunt, 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 cunt's the lot, I tell him. The word slides to my twat like a warm pat of butter. I guess I'll have to have some nigger, he says. Learning to ride. You always fit me well. The thrust of your ass always reached the small of my back. And even fat, I knew I'd drip sex between your legs. I've been riding you for years, and I'm thinking the wedding toast and that indie hit. May all your ups and downs be in the bedroom. Me, I'm more the addict sister than Rachel and Rachel getting married. And us, we're kind of a train wreck. I told you a book I was reading about what makes marriage work. Good sex, you asked? No. Fucking you, though, has always been speaking something more than I know to say. The conversation's ongoing, evolving, and these last few months like a 10 revival in the bedroom. My once uncertain orgasms erupt and erupt. You move to meet me like, really, you know me. Funny, we find this now, wandering as we are. We want each other in every other way. I see you sober and naked. You are mean, selfish, and petty. I do not know what you see as you stare through harsh light, but you are listless, disinterested. Certain is, this is love without condition. We fuck open, willing, knowing furrowed brows and spiteful eyes. I slide, wet, dripping, gaping, open, gasping. I feel you, all of you. Know your every twist, every curve, your arching moan. I do not need to know. Do I like you always? Do I want you always? I know an honest fuck. We ride this to the end.